Alright, where we're going? You can follow me.
Do a video on these cultivators.
These are called rotary. Oh, probably cultivators is what they call it. I'm really not sure. Rotary hose, cultivators. There's two ways you can put them on your tractor. Some people can put them on with these set screws. And I'll show you where that goes in a second. I personally like using these arms. And this is an older set that I haven't changed the bearings on or anything. Some people like putting them on like this. I just personally think they're too heavy to put on like this. So I like putting them on right here. But to do that, you have to make sure these arms are adjusted and this is raising up as high as it can. There is a left and right to these. And I'll show you how you can tell. Of course, one way that I know the left and right is because of the way I already have these arms set up. So this is going to go on the left side of the tractor, this is going to go on the right. Now, if you look at this spline, it has a flat place here and a beveled end here. The flat place always goes away from the center of the roll. Flat place away from the center of the roll. The bevels throw to the roll, throws to the roll. So that's how you know you're left and right with these. I have a, it's gonna be 15/16. I have a center bar on here right now, which we'll take loose. And this is where the cultivator is going to go. My fertilizer attachment is still on the tractor. To utilize this bar with a fertilizer attachment on it, you have to have this bent bar from International. And what it does, it allows for room to go around this cog right here. Cut that off real quick. Uh-oh, where's my knife? There it is. Hey, Sammy Bear.
Hey, Dad.
This is a set of 5-gang. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's a lot of 4-gang out there. Not too many 5s. A lot of tobacco farmers use 4-gangs. I like a 5 because it gets a little more closer to the roll. Well, actually to the wheel track, I should say. and they can be a little mean. Now what you want to do is slide that one all the way in, as far as you can get it, to give you room to put this one in, and then you'll pull that one back. Now if you'll get right here, Will. What we're trying to do, and this is with making rolls, cultivating anything, this is the center of the roll. This is always the center of the roll. When you're planting corn, anything, this is the center of the roll. So you want to divide the distance up of these rotavators to the center of this. So if I want it to be like that around the plant, that's what I'm going to divide it up to be. Close. I'll have to ride off center to roll a little bit. I don't know why. Why does that not go over as far? No bigger than that. That is what it is. Let's tighten it up. Oh man, I'm gonna have to use my adjustable, Sammy.
Wrench?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, and another thing. There's a wasp on one of those
plates. I see it. He's right here. Get up. Get out. Get out, or you're gonna get pinched. Come on, man, get out.
There you go.
We will get rid of a bee if we have to, but I don't have to. I don't.
Just gotta bump it away.
Particularly want to kill them. Right there. Only bad thing about 140s is over the years you get so much space in here. You can see it's probably got a good half inch travel in it. And I've actually seen some reproduction of these, and reproduction of this, and reproduction of this. I don't know how good the casting is. I doubt it as good as what IH forged. It could be, but I wished IH would have maybe did a grease fitting right here somewhere.
What size bolt is that?
15/16. Gonna try to do it lazy man way.
But the impact. When'd you get those cultivators?
A couple years ago. Right. This is the only set that I haven't rebuilt. I have a set of four gains that have very large tines on them.
You've rebuilt your cullivators?
Yes, you put these bearings. You can get the bearings off of. I wanted to say Tractor Supplies, and that's not right. No, it's in Raleigh. Ag Supply.
Because Napa will do your...
Ag Supply still sells a lot of stuff for 140 cultivators. They actually sell the feet. And they sell these brand new. There's some people on eBay that have these things. I mean, pretty much just junk. List it for $200-$300 a pair, and you can get them at Ag Supply for that. Brand new.
Napa does your oil filters on this thing, right?
Yes. Let me look at this one more time. Yeah, that's about right. I'll cheat on this in a little bit. Square bolt in there. Sometimes people break them and put a hex head bolt back in there, but it should be a square one, and that's what keeps it from turning. So now, since all we're going to cultivate is just a roll of potatoes before the grass gets bad, I'm just going to use my shoveled back feet. These back feet here I use most of the time just for laying off rolls, and they're called shovels. I'll get it soon. Well, and my spring arms, you see them, Will? You hear, Will? Some people want to use, if I can find a set. Oh, here. They like going through using these turning hose. That's okay too. It throws a little bit of dirt, but and then some of them put a set of these. I just like using these rotavators because they move the dirt and they're constantly building up a ridge. And by the way, this is a 1976 Farmall 140 that I got when I was working for DirecTV. I was at a guy's house and it was in the yard, and I asked him about it, and I didn't have enough money for the $1,200 that he wanted for it, and he hadn't run it in years, and the steering was, this was bent, the gas tank was bent. But he said it ran, so I asked him, I said, can I pay you $200 every 2 weeks when I get paid? And believe it or not, he said yes. And so every 2 weeks, I'd go by his house and pay him $200. And he let me take the tractor home. And we bought that and bought a gas tank for it. I think I rebuilt the carburetor and put a water pump on it, and it was pretty good. Growing up, I've had tractors. We had a 100 that I grew up on. My daddy had a 140, a 674 International, and we had to sell them when we quit farming tobacco, and I regretted selling them, and I missed the tractor, and I was just very thankful to get the opportunity to buy this booger. Here, well, let me show you a little closer on this. My last video, in case anybody's seen it. So, this plate right here, just this, was off of a 1010 John Deere fertilizer hopper. I took an International mount and welded this plate on it and drilled the holes and mounted this, and it's got a spacer right here too. Mounted this so that you could take it on any 140. So now it's just like the International base. I'll show you. So here's an International base, and as you can see, I did the same thing as I would have an International. Welded the plate on it, International bolts here, and this holds their hopper, and this holds a John Deere hopper. I just like that John Deere hopper because it controls the fertilizer flow real good. I have an International hopper. It's brand new, but I just hadn't used it. Man, that metal's thin.
I don't think I've ever seen you use that International base.
Well, I thought I had that spring, but I don't see it. Okay, so let's go down to the potato patch and cultivate one roll of potatoes. I don't have my tractor key, and I probably shouldn't tell this, but pretty much any small key will crank this thing up.